Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the next act in the Kiss FM Wango Tango Auditions. From right here in Los Angeles, let's give it up for Pink Slip.
As much as I hate to say it, I love 2003's Freaky Friday. This Lindsay Lohan and Jamie Lee Curtis comedy has become a true classic in my eyes, and my eyes only. The movie is about a mother and daughter that don't see eye to eye, and a racist stereotype notices their bickering one day and curses them to switch bodies overnight. It's pretty amazing. And though I've never seen the original, I can say this one is far better. Except there's one scene. No. One line. There's one line in this film that makes me dangerously upset.
No, now, up because my loneliness is killing me, and I must confess, I still believe.
No, not that one. Worse. This one.
Love. White Stripes.
Can't stand them.
Oh, I know, me neither. I mean, get a bass player.
Whoa, hold up. Get a bass player? Get a bass player. What the fuck? I can forgive this movie for a number of things. Its poorly developed and terribly performed side characters, its uncharismatic male love interest, and its blatant racism, but I cannot forgive this line. In fact, it stuck with me for years, and it's one of the few things I think most about. I'm not saying it keeps me up at night, but I'm not getting much rest writing this video. So what's wrong with this line? A number of things. You see, right now Lindsay Lohan is in her mother's body, making conversation with the love interest. They're talking about the bands they like. Now, throughout this movie, we're under the impression that Lindsay Lohan's character, Anna, isn't a complete fucking idiot and knows her shit about music. Until this line.
You get a bass player.
It completely shatters my suspension of disbelief. How can I see her as a competent human being if she's acting so goddamn retarded? The White Stripes didn't need a bass player. Their sound was full despite not having one. Their music, simple, but effective. Less is more. It was sloppy, dirty, and downright fucking awesome. And anyone who can't headbang to their music shouldn't have the right to live a normal life. You don't need a bassist, and they certainly didn't. Did Mozart need a bassist? Did Van Gogh need a bassist? Martin Luther King? Gandhi? Dr. Phil? No. Because you can accomplish a lot without one, and that's what the White Stripes did. In their run from their self-titled debut album till their glorious Icky Thump, the White Stripes consistently produced solid-sounding music that needed no more to it. I have to assume the writers of this movie, Heather Hawk and Leslie Dixon, don't know shit about shit. If this was a genuine opinion from either one of them, I fear for their safety and hope someone is taking care of them because they're so fucking stupid. And if this line was meant to be a funny little joke, hahaha, eat shit, because this hasn't been a joke to me at all. Quite frankly, I've been scared for years knowing someone has this opinion and shared it. Only a truly disturbed human being could have such an opinion. And sure, opinions are neither right or wrong, but this is the wrong opinion, and that's a fact. Ha ha ha, you heard that Seven Nation Army song that came out this year in 2003, which is this year? Yeah, I heard that garbage. It sucks. What makes you say that? There's no basis and I'm a fucking idiot. Oh. See, it don't make no sense. Which now forces me to believe this was an attempt at a joke, due to how ridiculous it really is. And I don't think there are any lines we shouldn't cross when it comes to jokes. I've always been an advocate for freedom in the exploration of our humor, no matter how offensive it can get. However, this isn't just offensive. It's not funny, and should never be joked about. Comedy is like medicine, and I fucking love medicine. No matter what it is, Zoloft, Klonopin, you just gotta take it, much like jokes. But some medicine is hard to take. You still gotta swallow it. Some medicine you can't get enough of. Yippee! But if we're to call this line a joke, then you're horribly mistaken. Comedy isn't supposed to make me feel so angry or scared. That joke isn't medicine. It's poison. To get a true understanding of comedy, you must watch 2001's Monkey Bone. This is my favorite film. It features Brendan Fraser and Whoopi Goldberg. The movie follows cartoonist Stu Miley, who created Monkey Bone, a successful comic strip based around a boner joke. One day, on the verge of his success, Stu gets in a horrible accident. His spirit then gets stuck in a place called Downtown. This is a place where all kinds of beings and imaginary creatures live. And wouldn't you know it? Monkey Bone is real, and he is here. Now, in order for Stu to wake from his coma, he must steal an exit pass from death. Stu manages to do this, but Monkey Bone steals the pass from him and enters the real world in Stu's body. It's kind of brilliant. Now, here's where it gets really funny. Monkey Bone does monkey thing in human body. But that's not all. Stu manages to come back to the real world, except he's in a body that's already been dead. So now he's running around as a corpse while licensed doctors are chasing him for his organs. It's basically what Freaky Friday tried to do, except it didn't display anything nearly as ridiculous as saying the White Stripes need a bassist. If you like this video, make sure to go fuck yourself, and if you're not subscribed already, good.